Hi everyone, I just created a short video here to show you how to create a tempo track based on the freely recorded MIDI tracks. By freely recorded I mean you have not used a metronome and you've played on your MIDI keyboard and you actually have some tempo changes in your piece of music here and you want to keep it that way. You don't want fixed tempo, you don't want the same, the notes sounding on the same way. You want some humanization, basically. And the problem with that is if you add more tracks, you want them to follow the same tempo changes. And in order to do that, you want to make sure that you create a tempo track that will show all the tempo changes so that the notes are kept on bars and beats. There are some tools to do that with Cubase Pro, but unfortunately, they're not available with Cubase Elements or Cubase Artist versions. And so although this demo is done with Cubase Pro, all the features I'm giving here can be used on Cubase Artist and Cubase Elements, hopefully. Anyway, so the first thing to do, so here you can see there is this track that I've recorded. As you can see, there are several problems. The first one is it doesn't start on the first beat of the first bar, so that's something we need to fix. And second, the tempo here, which is a default tempo, is not the tempo at which the notes are played here. And also, since it's a fixed tempo, we need to make sure that all these events here, these notes, occur on the right beats and tempo and bars, sorry. So to do that, the first thing, as I said, is to make sure we start on the first beat of the first bar. And to do that, we just double click here on the container. And so we get a closer look at the track here. And again, as you can see, the first notes in the first chord start after the first beat here. And I'm sorry, the second bar here. And so we want to change that. So to do that, we just type Command A or Control A if you're using Windows, and then here we just type the place where we want all this to start, so it will be 1.1.1.0, and bim, as you can see, everything has been shifted to the left. The durations have not changed, the relative positions of the notes haven't changed. It's just that everything starts at beat one of bar one. If you want to start at bar two, you can do the same thing and just type 2110 here instead of 1110. So now, as you can clearly see, for instance, this four chords, the first four chords here should be on beats and are clearly, completely offset here. And actually, if I have a look at the score, it's a big mess, okay? So we want to change that, and to do that we need to use a tempo track. So what we do here is we right click on the list of tracks here and then click add track tempo. Okay, so here is our tempo track, put it on the top here. Okay, so there's only one event right now on the tempo track, which is the default tempo that is the same as this one. And so we're going to need to change that. But also what we need to do is to go back to our MIDI track and click on the time base icon here so that it displays a clock here. And that clock means that you're in linear mode now. And what that means is that all the changes I'm going to do in the tempo track will be reflected on that particular MIDI track here. And so let's see how that happens. So I'm back to the tempo track. As you can see here, there's a small event here, which is the same as this here. So it says, okay, tempo will be 120, 120 beats per minute. And so we're going to change that. So what I do, I just select that and drag it down. And if you have a look at the bottom here, you can see that the positions of the notes do not change. However, I have changed where the bars and beats are displayed. And that's still, well, that's a good start, but that's not, doesn't work for all notes, as you can see, but it works pretty well for the first, say, five chords here, you know. So the first four chords are on beats, as you can see here, and the fifth one is on the first beat of the second bar, which is good. But then after that, you know, they're all shifted and not in the right place. So I'm going to do the same thing here. So I'm going to add, okay, let me see, yeah, grid bit, that's good. I'm going to add one even here in the tempo track. And then I want this chord here, these three notes here, to start on the third bar, okay? So on the third bar, I'm going to move here. Okay, so now I have all these six first chords here, which are good, you know. Okay, so let's assume that those three chords here should have half notes. Okay, so that means this chord here should be on the third beat of the third bar here. So just create a, okay, we create an event here, and then we move this, and then so this one here should be on the fourth bar here, and something like that, and therefore this one should be on the fifth, should be, so I see three, oh sorry, this one should be on four. There you go, and so this one should be on 4-3, something like that. Okay, so you see how this works. So it's, of course, it's a bit tedious, but unfortunately you have to do this once. But the good news is once you've done that, you know, for all the notes, then you don't have to do it for all their tracks and also to create the right score sheet. So that's pretty good. So let's move on. You know, done it in the background. So now you can see that all the notes are roughly positioned on the beats or eighths here. On quarter notes or eighth notes here, positions. And you can actually double check that by using the score view here. Okay, sorry, like this. And if you play it, you can visualize, you know, while it's playing, the MIDI notes here and the score here. So let's do that. That's it. So as you could hear, nothing has changed for the note durations, but now we can create a score sheet, we can create other MIDI tracks which will be able to synchronize with this one using the bars and beats and maybe the quantize feature, and so that's great. Now there is another method to do the same kind of thing, to synchronize tracks and to create score sheets, but it's probably less natural for a musician. You know, it consists in using the metronome to quantize, you know, the notes as you play them. And then after that, you play with a tempo track to change the tempo, basically. So that's what we're going to see now. Okay, so let's have a look at another method here to synchronize different tracks and also prepare for a score sheet. The other method consists in recording a first track like this, just like we did before, except this time we use a metronome. And if we play it, well, first of all, you see that although I did play manually, I kind of followed the metronome, and therefore all the notes are pretty much on the right position. There are still a few mistakes, like here, for instance, but we can fix that very easily. So the way I recorded it is like this, okay? Etc. So as you could hear, it's pretty much, you know, on position, but I want to make it exactly the right way. So in order to do that, it's easy. I just do command A or control A on Windows and then type Q. And if you have a closer look at what's going on, as you can see right now, those notes are a bit ahead here. And if I type Q, bim, they are on the right position. However, for that, I need to select the right grid, which I did by, you know, using the snap feature here. But also I need to select the right duration, and I selected quarter notes, which means all the notes will now be on at least on quarter notes. But the problem is here I had an eighth note, okay? So I'm going to undo that. Okay, so this is back with the, you know, the slight mistakes that I made when I recorded it. Now I select eighth note so that those notes will not be set to the closest quarter note, but to the closest eighth note. Well, all of them actually will be set to the closest eighth note. So once I have selected all of them, just type Q. In Cubase 10, you can click here, but on previous versions of Cubase, you had to click here to do something exactly similar to typing the key Q on your keyboard. So I'm going to use Q so that it's not confusing, the key. So if you have a look at this, or even at that, here, as you can see, those are a little bit late. Okay, and if I type Q, bim, they are all on the right position. Okay, so now that I've done that, what I want to do is, you know, make it sound better. In other words, I want to do some ritardandi and things like that to slow down the tempo a little bit. And also correct the initial tempo, which is too fast. You know, it's 100 tempo here. So if I create my tempo track, by the way, I keep this time, I'm using the musical time base, which means the time base that actually follows the tempos, as opposed to the one that, you know, keep the durations of the note and changes the bars and beats. So I keep it in musical mode, which is a little note like this, instead of, you remember, the clock before. So now it should be the note here. And from there, I create my my tempo track, as I did before. Put it on the top because I like it that way, but you don't have to. Okay, so the initial tempo is 80. Maybe I want it to be a little bit slower, so I'm gonna tell Cubase that I want to use the track, the tempo track. So using this small icon here, which should be lit on now. And here you can see the first event, which is a tempo at 80. So I'm gonna take it and drag it down a little bit, say to not much, maybe 75. of 70. Okay, why not? So if I play it, it's a bit slower than it was before. Okay, or I can actually, for the demo, maybe I'll do it faster so that you know, we don't have to wait too much to hear the effects. So let's put it at 80, for instance. Okay, that sounds good. Now, clearly what I want here, instead of having, you know, a note that comes exactly at the same time here on those four chords here, I want a ritardando here, and therefore I want those notes to, you know, take longer to be played. And to do that, I can see we start here at bar three, so I'm going to add an event here, and then I'm going to say from three to five, I'm going to slow down things. And as you can see, now not only the tempo lines, you know, the bars and beats are expanded a little bit like this, but all the notes are following that. And therefore, as you can see, they will last longer as we progress in time. Another thing to note is that here, as you can see, there's a ramp here, and you can select whether you want a ramp or a direct jump here by using the small icon here, because I want it to be smooth, you know, not I don't want all these notes to be exactly slower the same way. I want to slow down progressively. Okay, so that's why I'm using a ramp here. And then after the ramp, I want to go back, for instance, to the initial tempo, which was 90. So I will add another time event here at 90. Okay. Okay, so that's 95. I can actually correct it here if I want to. There you go. And now if I listen to it, I will hear the tempo slow down for these notes and then come back up here. Etc. And now I can create other tracks, and you know, MIDI tracks, and use the same principle and follow the same tempo track here so that all the tracks are in sync. And of course, I can create a score sheet as usual. That's it. I hope it's useful for you guys. And if you have questions, well, you can always comment the video. Thank you for listening, and have a great time composing music.